We've got a lot of people in the church, especially, who are graced, gifted, and anointed to be amazing number twos, like phenomenal number twos, like crushing it number twos. But for whatever reason, they feel pressured and or called to be number ones. And so they, instead of being phenomenal number twos, they become mediocre number ones at best. And I don't know why this happens. Well, I do know why, which is why I'm recording this video. For whatever reason, we have lost the art of being Scottie Pippen or Kelly Rowland. Scottie Pippen realized at some point he's not Michael Jordan. Phenomenal basketball player, he's just not Michael Jordan. Kelly Rowland had to realize, phenomenal singer, incredible entertainer, but she's not Beyonce. For whatever reason in the church, we don't have enough people who are willing to admit, I'm gifted, I'm awesome, I'm graced, I'm anointed, but I'm just not the number one leader. And in today's video, we're gonna talk about how to distinguish between a number two gift and a number one gift, because when everyone operates in their lane, the church grows, and that's the goal. How about you keep watching today's video? Let's go. Maybe 2 years ago, we were doing a conference at my church called Flood Conference, and we booked Pastor Michael Todd. I mean, man, like this was maybe like right at the brink of like when he started becoming who he is today. I mean, he hadn't even preached at Elevation yet. He had gone viral. It was like Michael Todd was in the process of becoming Michael Todd. And we're hanging out at a restaurant after one of the conference sessions. And he was telling me about this new person that he had just hired at his church. This guy's name was Charles Metcalf. And Charles Metcalf had raised a bunch of money to be a to start his church. He was on the way to being a senior pastor. He had actually already become a senior pastor. He had launched his church. And Charles Metcalf decided that instead of doing his own thing, instead of being a number one, which he had the money to do, the resources to do, the gift to do, the preaching acumen to do that, instead of being a number one on his own, he decided to give up all of that, to literally leave his church and to merge his church with Mike Todd's church and to serve Pastor Michael Todd's vision. And I remember being blown away by this. I remember thinking to myself, oh my gosh, this is kingdom. This is humility. This is confidence. This is all the good things. This is phenomenal. And then I remember being struck with the fact that this is the only story like this that I know about. That Charles Metcalf is the only Scottie Pippen in the church world that I'm really aware of. He's the only Kelly Rowland that I'm really aware of. The art of being Kelly Rowland is that Kelly Rowland realizes that although she is gifted, although she is wealthy, although she is an entertainer, although she is freaking phenomenal, she would be better like as a complementary piece on a group known as Destiny's Child. Now, for those of you who may not know about Destiny's Child, Destiny's Child actually used to have two women on the squad named LaToya and LaTavia. And I bet you when LaToya and LaTavia left Destiny's Child, I bet you they talked smack about Beyonce. They said that they were going to go off and be famous. They didn't need Beyonce. They could probably sing better than Beyonce. What LaToya and LaTavia didn't understand, though, is that they were talking about Beyonce. See, to them, Beyonce was just Beyonce, you know? They had known Beyonce for a long time. They had gotten desensitized to the Beyonce-ness. But Kelly Rowland wisely never got desensitized to the Beyonce-ness of Beyonce. And so Kelly Rowland right now is way more successful than LaToya or LaTavia, and her career has been phenomenal because she learned her role. She learned her role and she knew who she was and who she wasn't. And that takes confidence. That takes real confidence. Pretending to be someone that you're not is not confidence. That is hubris. That's actually pride. And for a lot of people, it's delusional. There are so many people who would be amazing number twos, phenomenal number threes, But for whatever reason, they decide, I'm going to go start my own church. I'm going to go be a senior pastor. Man, I'm 33 years old. At the time of this recording, I've never been a number one. Don't know if I'm ever going to do that. Because I don't know if I'm Beyonce. Like, I don't know if I'm Mike Todd. I may be a great Charles Metcalf, though. I have no idea if I'm Michael Jordan. But you know what? I could probably be a great Scottie Pippen. And there's a lot of people that I'm looking at and I'm going, man, if I'm unsure about whether or not I am that gifted, and I'm a pretty gifted individual, whoo, you're making a lot of assumptions about your level of giftedness. And what happens when we make assumptions that are selfish and prideful? Actually, the body of Christ suffers. When I look at Transformation Church, when I look at everything that God's been able to do at Transformation Church, of course, I see the stellar communicator and leader that is Pastor Mike Todd. But then I see all these other role players and I go, man, that's a healthy team. If you're watching this and you're a guy and you're normal, you've probably watched The Last Dance. In The Last Dance, one of the things that became glaringly obvious is that Michael Jordan, although he's the heart and soul of that Bulls team, without a phenomenal coach, they're not winning six times. Without Scottie Pippen, they're not winning six times. Without Dennis Rodman, they're not winning six times. Actually, without the GM that everybody gets annoyed with, without a great owner, they're not winning six times. There are so many keys or pieces to that puzzle that allows them to win six times. And even with someone like Michael Jordan on your team, you can end up losing over and over and over and over and over again. So I want to challenge everybody. If you are Beyonce, please make sure that you find a Kelly Rowland and recruit that person and keep that person. Make sure that you treat that person well because you actually need them. I get it, you're a superstar, but you're going to need role players to do their job. And if you're a Kelly Rowland, please don't be like LaToya or Latavia. Don't assume that because you're close to Beyonce that the world sees this person the way you see this person. Actually, you may really underestimate the value of a Beyonce because you've been around that person for so long. I think the kingdom of God, like the church, capital C church, needs way more Scottie Pippens, Kelly Rowlands, and Charles Metcalfs. And I think that would make the church so much healthier. We'd avoid burnout. We'd avoid putting all the weight of leadership on one person. We actually need all the number twos to realize, man, this is a beautiful role that God has graced me to have, and I don't need to be jealous of the leader or compare myself to the number one leader. I actually need to come around that leader and run in my lane at my pace and do my job and know my role. I was listening to ESPN recently, and this ESPN analyst was saying that in the last however many years that Stephen Curry, Kevin Durant, LeBron James, and Kawhi Leonard, that there hasn't been a finals in the past, I can't remember how many years, that one of those four players has not been in. That these four players are the only number ones in the NBA right now. The conversation was relevant because James Harden, Russell Westbrook, and Giannis were all either thinking about being traded or trying to figure out what to do. And this analyst was saying, yeah, James Harden, although he's a gifted player, is not a number one. Russell Westbrook is just not a number one. That Giannis is just not a number one. That in the entire NBA, there are only four guys who are number one players, killers, like the kind of people you build entire teams and franchises around. And I think if that's true in the NBA, it's even more true in the kingdom. We got a lot of number twos, stressed out, anxious, overworked, burdened. I mean, a lot of number twos who are carrying number one level weight that they should not be carrying. And maybe this video is where somebody who you don't even know can say, honestly, hey, you don't have to carry it. Like, if you quit right now and you told a senior pastor who is a number one. I want to support you. I want to work for you. I want to build a kingdom with you. That senior pastor would be ecstatic. And I think we need more people like that. More senior pastors who are really number twos, but are fronting like they're number ones to lay their churches at the feet of men of God who are actually number ones. And to do something different. And I think that that is the spirit of unity. And I think that the church would be better off for it. Hey, in 30 years, I may disagree with this video. But as of 2021, this is my opinion. And I think that anyone who's willing to take a secondary role based on their gifts, actually assessing their gifts. If you're a number one person, you won't be able to hide. You won't. Pastor Michael Todd was a drummer, music producer, and God put him where he is right now. I think there are a lot of people who are number ones who are hiding in churches. God knows, it's okay. But there are a lot of people, the issue that I really wanted to tackle in this video is the opposite issue. People who are number twos and they have put weight on themselves that is crushing them. And if that's you, hey, hopefully this video inspires you to make some changes. I would love for you to subscribe to this channel or to share this video if it was helpful. Even if you disagree with me, let me know in the comments. I love if you would engage with this content, interact with this channel. I hope that this video added value to your life. Can't wait to see you next week. Peace!